Hello students, how are you all? I hope that you all are in good health and high spirits. Today, we shall have some fun with numbers. Radhika, Gauri, Vicky, Indra and Sunil were collecting Imli or tamarind seeds. You also might play with your friends. Similarly, these children were also playing with Imli seeds. Radhika collected 24 seeds. Gauri collected 47 seeds. Sunil got 38 seeds.
Indra collected
54 and Vicky had got 42 seeds. Now fill in the blanks with correct answers. First is Dash collected the most seeds. Students, let's see the table again. You can see the table that shows the number of seeds collected by all students. Let's see who collected the most seeds. Students, you can see the most number of seeds in the table is 54. And these are collected by
Indra.
It means
Indra collected
the most seeds. Thus, the answer is
Indra collected
the most seeds. Next is Sunil will collect dash more seeds to be equal to Vicky. See students, Vicky collected 42 seeds and Sunil had got 38 seeds. So how many seeds does Sunil need to get equal seeds to Vicky? See, Sunil has 38 seeds. So let's count. 39, 40, 41 and 42. So how many seeds does he need? 4. So he needs 4 more seeds so that he gets equal seeds to be equal to Vicky. Next is, if Radhika gets 6 more seeds, she will have dash seeds. Look students, how many seeds had Radhika collected? 24. Now if she gets 6 more seeds, then let's count it on her fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It means 25, 26, 27, 28, 29 and 30.
So, it means if Radhika gets 6 more seeds, then how many seeds will she have? 30.
Next is, how many children have more than 40 seeds? Let's look in the table. One is Gauri, who has 47 seeds.
Then is Indra,
who has 54 seeds. And then is Vicky, who has 42 seeds. So how many students are there who have more than 40 seeds? 3. So 3 children are there who have more than 40 seeds. Next is, Dash needs 3 more seeds to have 50 seeds. Look here students, which child is there who will get 50 seeds if he or she gets 3 more? So it is Gauri. As you can see, Gauri has 47 seeds and If she gets 3 more seeds, she will have 50 seeds. So the answer is Gauri. Next is Sunil has 2 seeds less than 40 and Dash has 2 seeds more than 40. Let's find out. It is Vicky who has 2 seeds more than 40, as Vicky has 42 seeds. Isn't it interesting? Now let's play another interesting game. This is dot game. Guess the number of dots in the pictures. First of all, we have a very cute deer. Let's count the number of dots in this deer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and this very tiny 8. So how many dots are there in this deer? 8. There are 8 dots in this deer. Let's move forward. We have this tired and exhausted hyena. Let's count the number of dots in this hyena. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. So this hyena has 15 dots. Next, we have an otter. Let's count the number of dots in this otter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how many dots this otter has? 5. Next we have this dreadful lizard. Oh my god, I'm so scared of lizards. Thank god this lizard is not in front of me. It's there in the book. Let's count the number of dots in this lizard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Some children might think that these two dots on the top are also the dots on its body. But no, they are this lizard's eyes. Next we have a beautiful fish. Let's count the number of dots on this fish. We have to count all small and big dots on this fish. Let's start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. So this fish has 18 dots. Wasn't it interesting? I hope you all enjoyed counting the number of dots on the fish, otter, lizard, and the deer. Now let's go forward. Dhoni's century. My dear students, do you know who is Dhoni? I hope you all know him very well. His full name is Mahendra Singh Dhoni, and he was captain of Indian cricket team. I hope you still remember his powerful sixes. Today, we shall discuss about one of his matches. India was playing a one-day international match against South Africa at Guwahati. Students, Guwahati falls in Assam. In this match, India was batting first. Dhoni is batting on 96 and only one ball is left. Will he be able to complete his century? Let's see. Here comes the last ball. Wow! What a powerful six! Now students, tell me, was he able to complete his century? Yes, he was. Students, do you know how many runs are there in one century? Yes, a century has 100 runs. 100 runs make a century. Now let us fill in the blanks. Dhoni made 96 plus dash equal dash runs. So he hit a 6 after 96 on the last ball. So 96 plus 6 means how many runs? Let's count. 97, 98, 99, 100, 101 and 102. So Dhoni made 102 runs. Next question is, how many runs do these players need to complete a century? Here we have a table showing some players and their runs. So we need to find the number of runs that these players need to score to complete their century. Player 1 has made 93 runs. So how many runs does he need to complete his century? Let's count. 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99 and 100. So he needs to score 7 runs to complete his century. So player 2 has got 97 runs. So how many runs does he need to complete his century? Yes, 3 runs. Player 3, he has made 89 runs. How many runs does he need to complete his century? Let's see. 89 plus 1 gives 90. And 90 plus 10 gives 100. So he needs 1 plus 10, that is 11 runs to complete his century. And player 4, he has made 99 runs. So how many runs does he need to complete his century? Only 1. Students, let's move forward. Forward from 99. Question 1 is, fill in the blanks. We have got numbers from 99 to 112. Let's see. 99, 100, 101. So what will come next? 102. Then 103, 104. What will come next? 105. That is 105. Then 106. And then 107. So what will come next? 108. Next is 109. 110, 111 and 112. So in the next table we have got numbers from 195 to 206. Let's complete this table. 196 197, 198, 199, 200, 201, and the next will be 202. Then 203, and the next will be 204. Then 205, and the last will be 206. I hope you enjoyed filling this table. Now let's move forward. 206. Can you guess how many more runs are required to score a triple century? Triple century means 300 runs. What a wonderful player he might be who would score 300 runs in an innings. Now, if that player is on 206, then how many more runs does he need to score after 206? Complete a triple century. Let's count. If 10 is added to 206, we get 216. If we add 20, we get 226. If we add 30, we get 236. If we add 40, we get 246. If we add 50, we get 256. If we add 60, we get 266. If we add 70, we get 276. 80, 286. If we add 90, so we get 296. And then if we add 4, so we get 300. It means 90 plus 4 gives 94. So the batsman needs 94 runs if he wants to score a triple century. In this table, you have been shown top 10 scores in a Cricket World Cup. APJ has scored 128 runs. AS has scored 100 runs. CK 99 runs. DM 162 runs. KSP 152 runs. MD 178 runs. PK 105 runs. ST 141 runs. TPK 112 runs. And VVS 127 runs. Now let's find out. CK just missed his century. How many runs did he need to make a century? Let's see the table again. How many runs has CK scored? 99. And how many runs does he need to complete a century? Only 1. So he missed his century by 1 run. Next is Dash and Dash scored almost equal runs. Now let's see in the table which players have scored almost equal runs. As you can see in the table, APJ has made 128 runs and VVS has made 127 runs. They are almost equal, APJ and VVS. Similarly, AS has made 100 runs and CK has made 99 runs. These are also almost equal. So we have two pairs of players who have made almost equal runs, APJ and VVS, and AS and CK. They have scored almost equal runs. Next is, Dash scored a complete century, no less, no more. So we can clearly see in the table, which player has scored exactly 100 runs? AS, exactly 100, no less, no more. So it is AS who has scored exactly 100 runs. Next is, most runs scored by any batsman are Dash. As you can see in the table, most runs are 178 and they have been scored by MD. So MD has scored most runs and that is 178. This was really very interesting. Let's move forward. Counting in tens. The best way of counting in tens is that we add 10 to the numbers, or we can add 10 numbers together. For example, counting in tens, the number that comes after 10 is 20. Also, 10 plus 10 gives 20. We can also count 10 numbers after 10. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Now let's count. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and 100. Similarly, we will complete the next column. 110, 120, 130, 140, 150, 160, 170, 180, 190, and 200. Similarly, students, we can complete the next column. It starts with 310, next will be 320, 330, 340, 350, 360, 370, 380, 390, and 400. Now let's complete the last column. It starts with 710. So next number will be, counting by tens, it will be 720, 730, 740, 750, 760, 770, 780, 790, and last will be 800. Next is counting in 50s. As we counted in tens, the same way we will count in 50. The best way of doing this is, we will count with a difference of 50. For example, counting in 50s after 10, the next number will be 60. Like 10 plus 50 gives 60. Let's do it. The first number is 200. So the next number counting in 50s will be 50 more than 200, that is 250. And the next number will be 300. So we are adding 50s in each number. So the next number will be 350, then 400, then 450, 500, 550, then 600, 650, 700, 750, 800 and 850. So we have counted by 50s. Next is color the numbers. Now find these numbers in the chart and color them on the table. Students, we have been given some numbers in the chart and we have to find these numbers in the table and color them. Let's see. The first number given in the chart is 140. Let's find this number in the table. Here it is. Now we will color it green. Next number is 202. Let's find out 202. Here it is, 202. We have to color it in green. Here we are. Next number is 261. Let's find out where is 261. Here it is. And we have to color it in green. So let's do it. Here we are. We have colored 261 in green color. Next number given in the chart is 800. Let's find out where is 800. Can you help me? Here it is, in the first column. 800. This is 800. So we have to color it in what color? Green. So here we are. We are coloring 800 in green. Next number given in the chart is 300 plus 70 plus 4. First, we have to find out what number is this. So, 300 plus 70 gives 370 and adding 4 gives us 374. So let's find out 374 in the table. Here it is, 374, 374. We have to color it in one color, that is green color. Here we are. Next number is 600 plus 50 plus 6. So we have to color it in green. So let's find out what number is this. 600 plus 50 gives 650 and adding 6 gives us 656. So we will find out 656. 656. Here it is, and we will color it in green color. Next number is 5 plus 50 plus 100. So we add them. 100 plus 50 gives 150 and adding 5 gives us 155. So let's find out 155. Here it is, 155. So we have to color it in one color, green. Here we are. Now let's see the chart. Next number that is given is 54. Let's find out where is 54. Here it is. But now we have to color it in red color. So let's color it red. Here we are. Next number is 60. That's easy to find. Here it is, 6060. So we have to color it in what color? Red. Let's color it in red. Here we are. Next number that we have been given is 195. Let's find out 195. Here it is in the first column. 195. 195. We have to color it in one color, red. So let's color it red. Next number is 555. Let's find out. 555. Here it is. We have to color it in what color? Red. Here we are. Next number is 600 plus 40 plus 2. Let's find the number first. 600 plus 40 will give us 640, and adding 2 will give us 642. That is 642. Let's find it out in the chart. Sorry, in the table. Here it is. 642. Let's color it in red. Next number is 100 plus 70 plus 9. It makes 179. Let's find out. Here it is. And we have to color it in what color? Red. So let's color it red. Next number is 800 plus 10. That is 810. 810. Here it is on the top. So let's color it in what color? Red. That's right. Now let's move forward. Next number we have been given is 445. 445. Let's find out. Here it is. And we have to color it in what color? Yellow. There we are. Next number is 16. That's very easy. Here it is. And we have to color it in what color? Yellow. Next number is 159. So that is 159. Let's find out. Here it is. We have to color it in what color? Yellow. We have to color it in yellow color. Next number is 685. Let's find out. Where is 685? Where is 685? Here it is. We have to color it in what color? Yellow. There we are. Next number is 600 plus 90 plus 9. That makes 699. 699. Here it is. We have to color it in what color? Yellow. There we are. Next number is 70 plus 4. That makes 74. 7 and 4. Let's find out. Here it is. And we have to color it in yellow. Next number is 1 plus 90 plus 80. So students, 90 plus 80 makes 170. And adding 1 will give us 171. 171. Let's find out in the table. Here it is. So we have to color it in what color? Yellow. So wasn't it an interesting game? We found out so many numbers in the table and we colored them. I found it very interesting. I hope you like this game too. Now, let's have some fun with jumping animals. Yes, jumping animals. Isn't it interesting? Let's find out. Gabru, Bunny and Taru are jumping all the way. Gabru jumps on every 7th box. Bunny on every 5th box. Taru on every 4th box. Gabru starts jumping from number 90. Bunny starts jumping from number 99. Taru starts jumping from number 106. Now tell, who will jump on which number? Students, Bunny's 10th jump is on number dash. We can see that Bunny is at 99 and in one jump, he jumps on every 5th box. So this way, we get 99 plus 5 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 plus 5. So that makes 149. So he will jump on 149 after 10 jumps. Next, we have to find Taru's 10th jump is on dash. Now see, he is at 106 and jumps on every 4th box. So this way, 106 plus 4 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 plus 4. That will give us 146. So he will be on 146 after 10 jumps. Next, we have to find Gabru's 10th jump will be on number dash. Now she's at 90 and jumps on every 7th box. So this way, 90 plus 7 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 and plus 7. It gives 160. So she will be on 160 after 10 jumps. Students, let's see the table again. We have put circles on all numbers in the table. This will help you understand very well. Now Taru and Bunny jump on numbers dash. If we see on which numbers will Taru and Bunny both will jump, so we can see that both are jumping on numbers 114, 134, 154 and 174. Now, is there any box on which all three will jump? You can see there is one number, 174, which is shown in all the three columns. It means 174 is that number on which all three will jump. Next is Lazy Crazy Shop. This shopkeeper takes money in a crazy way. He takes only 100 rupee note, 10 rupee note and 1 rupee coin. Now the question is, whatever these animals have purchased, how will they pay for it? The elephant. He has purchased items for rupees 420. So how many 100 rupee notes he will give? 4.
That makes 400. How many 10 rupee notes will he give? 2. That makes 20. And how many coins of 1 rupee he will give? 0. Thus, the money that the elephant will give will be 400 plus 20, that is 420. Next is, the rabbit has purchased items for rupees 143. So, how many 100 rupee notes he will give? 1. How many 10 rupee notes will he give? 4. And how many coins of 1 rupee he will give? 3. Thus, the money that the rabbit will give will be 100 plus 40 plus 3. That is 143. Similarly, the monkey has purchased items for rupees 242. So, how many 100 rupee notes he will give? 2. How many 10 rupee notes will he give? 4. And how many coins of 1 rupee he will give? 2. So thus, the money that the monkey will give will be 200 plus 40 plus 2. That makes 242. Similarly, the deer has purchased items for rupees 55. So he won't give any 100 rupee note. Then, how many 10 rupee notes will he give? 5. And how many coins of 1 rupee he will give? 5. Thus, the money that the deer will give will be 50 plus 5. That is 55. Next is, who am I? Match with the number. I come between 40 and 50, and there is a 5 in my name. So students, the numbers that come between 40 and 50 are 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48 and 49. So out of these, what will have 5 in its name? Yes, it will be 45. Now match this with 45. Next is, I have 9 in my name and am very close to 90. So, can you find out what number is very close to 90 and has a 9 in its name? Yes, it is 89. Next is, if you hit a 4 after me, you score a century. So, that means, what is 4 less than a century? Century is 100 runs. 4 less than 100 is 96. So if you hit a 4 after 96, you will score a century. So join this to 96. Next is, I am equal to 10 knots of 10. That's very easy. 10 knots of 10, what will you get? 100. So join this to 100. Next is, I am century plus half century. So students, century means 100 and half century means 50. So 150 means 150. That means century plus half century means 150. So let's join it to 150. Next one is, I am exactly in between 77 and 97. So the number that comes exactly between 77 and 97 will be 87. So students, isn't it interesting? You can also play many such games and riddles with your friends. So today, what we have done? We had a lot of fun with numbers. Thank you.